basic concepts now we are discussing. Okay. So this is information processing and retrieval, the basic concepts. So the first, the term information retrieval was coined by Kelvin Moores. So already we discussed in the last class, retrieval phrase was coined by Kelvin Moores over 50 years ago. But it gained its popularity in the research community after about a decade, in the early 60s. So what is the significance of early 60s are, those time the computers were being introduced in information handling. And this, since then, the this term, the information retrieval, was then being used to mean retrieval of bibliographic information from stored document databases. Next, in this, early information retrieval systems were designed to retrieve an entire document in response to a search request. In other words, we can say that the retrieval systems were also designed to retrieve an entire document, that is, either it may be a book or an article which was published in journals, etc. And over the years, many advanced techniques have been developed and applied to design information retrieval systems. And the concept, the idea of information retrieval also changed, and it has been variously termed by professionals and researchers. So what are the terms you observe? Information storage and retrieval, information organization and retrieval, information processing and retrieval, text retrieval, and information representation and retrieval, and information access. So the idea of retrieval has been changed from time to time, and various terms are also included in that term. And in the next slide, so this slide depicts the definition of information retrieval. Information retrieval refers to techniques for the storage and retrieval of information from the document databases. We can simply use retrieval to refer the techniques. So what are those techniques? The technique of storage and the technique of retrieval of information from the document databases. So in simple terms, we can say that retrieval is nothing but, retrieval is nothing but to retrieve the information from the stored document databases. And next, growth and development of computers and telecommunication technologies have added new dimensions to information retrieval systems. In this area, the foundations of computerized information retrieval was laid by H.P. Lack in 1957. He is the person who developed computerized information retrieval in 1957. Since then, the researchers applied this computer technology in different areas of retrieval, like automatic searching and retrieval. So the development of telecommunication technologies also enabled the user community throughout the world to share information resources. With the development of telecommunication, computer networks came into existence. So with the help of networks, we can share information resources from the remotely located databases. So this area is popularly known as online retrieval. So, which provides access to more than one user at a time to a number of remotely located databases. So, with the help of online retrieval, we can provide access to more than one user at a time. So, next, this slide depicts the process of retrieval. There is a process in retrieval. So, what is that process? It is the operation by which items are selected from a collection. The process of retrieval takes place repeatedly in every search for information. So in every search for information, the process is continue, the process is goes on. We can say that the process is goes on in every search for information. So we can say that, for example, to clarify the subject search, define its terms, decide its scope, we scan encyclopedias, dictionaries, and other reference books. Either the text or the index to these books is arranged in some regular way, that is alphabetically. So what is the meaning of this sentence is, if we want to clarify any subject research, for example, history or political science or economics or any subject research, first what can we do? We need to define the terms, and also we need to decide the scope of that subject. So, define the definitions of terms, as well as we need to know the scope of the subject. So, what are the sources which are helpful, which helps us to us, means encyclopedias and dictionaries and other reference books. So, these are the tools which we can search for a subject, and we can also define its terms and also decide the scope of any subject. So what are the sources to clarify the subject search means encyclopedias, dictionaries and other reference books are the sources. Like that, in the next example, so to get an introduction to a subject, we need to identify suitable textbooks. So if you search for any introduction to history, introduction to economics of a subject, we need to identify some suitable textbooks, the fundamentals of textbooks which published in the particular subject. So for that purpose, in the library, how can we search for textbooks? With the help of a catalog, we can scan catalogs, and with the help of catalogs, we can locate the exact location of any textbook or document in the particular library. So here catalog helps us. And in the next example, reference to articles or abstracting journals and current issues of journals. If we want to search any article published in journals, so what is the source? What can we see? Where can we see? So in the current issues of journals. In our library science, there are number of current journals or ongoing journals like Indian Library Association Bulletin, IASLIC Bulletin, DISDOC journals, and so many national and international journals. So we can search articles in that journals. So here the process of retrieval simply goes on in every search for information. And what are the retrieval tools which we are helpful, which are helpful to us, means here there are number of tools, encyclopedias, dictionaries, catalogs and current issues of journals. And in the this is the slide which reflects the common structure of retrieval system. Here in any retrieval system, words are arranged in some order, most probably in alphabetical order, and there are identifiers, references, and also known as codes are also there, and document locations, and there are other words also to extend search. So if you want to know, or if you see any structure of retrieval system, there is a common structure. Commonly we can find here in words. Words are also there. Page numbers or identifiers are also there. The document locations are also there. And other words like cross references are also there to extend search. And Here there are four phases in the operation of retrieval system. So there are words, references, documents and data. If you want to search the meaning for a word, we can scan dictionaries. So dictionary is the retrieval tool of searching a word, and as at the same time index is the retrieval tool for the location of references, and also shelf list is the retrieval tool for document location, and for handbook is the retrieval tool for locating the data. So this is the structure of retrieval system, and we are also discussed in this slide the four phases in the operations of retrieval system. And in this slide depicts the purpose of retrieval system. So what is the purpose of retrieval system means it aims at collecting and organizing information in one or more subject areas in order to provide it to the users as soon as he asked for. So any retrieval system has its own purpose. So what is the purpose means it the purpose of retrieval system mainly concentrates on collecting as well as organizing the information in one or more subject areas. Any retrieval system need to collect the information, at the same time it has to organize the information. So what is the purpose or how the retrieval system can organize the information? Why for its organized information means to provide information for users. So that is the purpose of retrieval system. So there is an author, Belkin, a writer. So he presents the purpose of retrieval system. So according to Belkin, an author presents a set of ideas. There will be some users who require that ideas but may not be able to identify those information. So there are number of authors who presents their ideas, and there are also users who require, who need that ideas but may not be able to identify those information. So users are not able to identify the information, and for this occasion retrieval system serves to match the writer's ideas with users' requirements. It acts as bridge between the creators of information and the users of that information. So the retrieval system comes or acts as a mediator, or it acts as a bridge between the creators of, or creators means here nothing but the authors who publish the, who write the books. So who creators, authors of information as well as the users of that information. So retrieval system